That's why people don't explore possibility, because possibility provokes that uncomfortable feeling that comes with knowing something's better for you, but you're not willing to give up on what you have.
I did it on Saturday, or whenever it was that I sent you that Teams message, but it won't go through or post until today because it's a banking app. Know thyself. We've gone well past that. It's like, you better know thyself and be willing to broadcast to thyself. And if you don't love yourself, that's going to be very uncomfortable. There's lots of people who think they're working. They've never worked a day in their life. They don't give a fuck. It's not a discipline or a practice or a ritual. It's an activity or a reaction that they're engaged in because their life depends upon it, but they hate it. Right? It's totally different. It's one thing to show up and like, oh, I'm here at my workout and like take yourself to what, 40, 50, 60% of effort. But then if you show up and someone cares and you put in the effort, you get results. It's a waste of time to do something you don't value. People who brute force their values, for example, it's like, well, I don't enjoy this thing, but I'm going to do it anyway as some form of martyring or punishment on myself. It's really perverted to believe that that's a way to earn shit in life, is to literally be forced to suffer, to endure undue torture, self-inflicted torture by doing shit you don't enjoy, when the only thing keeping you from enjoying it is your willingness to see how it nets a return on investment in the form of your values. You just look. Any perceived painful thing can be turned into a pleasurable thing. Look at how it yields you a return on what's important in life. You won't invest in it if you don't see how it'll produce a return. None of us will. The whole concept of human beings essentially being a value exchange organism at a principle, it's like the fundamental unit is value exchange, which demands a perception of return on investment. Period. That concept we were discussing yesterday, I want to make a topic of something around world building too, because I've been looking like, what do I find so inspiring about the Marvel Universe? And it's the world building. And I just pasted a link. That dude wrote an article. I put it in team chat this morning. It's basically this essay. And he talks in the essay about how essentially content marketing is world building. It's no different than the Avengers universe. It's context and story. So what the whole point of content marketing is about is world building, context, and storytelling, period. Then on top of that, we initiate transactions that serve people, period. Two separate, totally binary systems. It's like any Taurus in the world, they have that line. They're always connected, but they don't directly touch. A magnet is like these two rings. Now imagine a ring that goes through those rings that's invisible. The ring that goes through the rings is the quantum field. That's been demonstrated in a study. So all systems are binary, linked in an entanglement state that's not materially connected.
What time is it? All right, let's start at the top. 8:50 on August 13th.
All right, what's up guys? August 13th, it's Monday morning, 8:50 a.m. I'm here in Calgary, Alberta, and I've been up since 4. Yesterday, we launched a significant content strategy. We're gonna be deploying a significantly higher amount of content to all platforms effective immediately. It's one of these things that happened, it sort of slipped by late on a Sunday afternoon. Steven and I were working together to essentially curate this week's content calendar, which by the time you're watching this episode, hopefully you've already seen some of. If you did, please comment, let me know what you thought. You have challenges producing content in your business. I know that because I have challenges and I'm probably producing more than you. I've made content production and content capture a discipline and a practice in my life now for 6 or 7 years. That process has evolved. It started with an iPhone on a white paper canvas with a lighting kit that I bought online. Bought it while I was in Houston, it showed up. I asked my girlfriend to set it up for me so that I could get back from my trip, go to my video studio and practice producing content. I did that at that time because I was investigating all of the different topics related to acquiring new customers for my business. I didn't have the clearest packaging, I didn't have the clearest offers, I didn't know how to communicate necessarily in the values of my customer. Arguably, I didn't even know how to tell you who my customer was. But what I did know was that it was gonna be necessary for me to figure out how to go out and be in the world and be relevant and to inspire people to want to engage with me, because I felt like I had something to share with them. I felt like something I could do for them was valuable. I felt like I could change their life in some way. It's been 7 years. What have we done? A whole lot of practicing, a whole lot of learning, a whole lot of purchasing of technology, to be honest. We've spent a lot of time working with business owners, helping them to deploy technology. We started by building computers for Memory Express, and that transformed into helping small business owners by supporting and servicing their entire end user base, building and managing their network infrastructure, supporting and maintaining their servers, etc. Having that opportunity to be so embedded into these businesses who gave me the opportunity to work with them, I saw all of the different and unique problems and opportunities facing these customers. These customers learned to depend on me as a person who was most willing to take ownership of a problem. I show up, and whether that problem was something that was related to the computer or something that wasn't, I approached every problem the same way. How can I become in ownership of this problem, and how can I make sure that I solve it? Because I don't perceive that anyone else is willing to pick up the ball. So I took those skills, and I've learned over time that marketing is essentially reverse engineering what's important and meaningful to my customers, and then telling stories and producing content that aligns with those needs. It means helping people solve problems. It means helping people see perspectives that are different from their own, helping people form higher quality questions, helping people see that a different potential exists in their mind so that they can potentially create that in their world. You're never gonna think to produce content you don't see or believe in. You're never gonna think to solve a problem you haven't witnessed. You're never gonna be able to capture an opportunity you don't see. And the same applies to your customer. So here's the question: where's your customer looking, and how do you get there? Because the key is you have to solve their problem, but you can't do that until you have their attention. And in today's democratized economy of attention, any human being on this planet at any time can look down at this magic box in their hands and gain access to a whole world of information and a whole world of voices, some of which might be yours. The question is, how frequently and how relevantly do you appear in front of a potential audience who may be interested in your products or services? What is the pure quantity? I don't even care about quality, because it doesn't matter if you haven't put in any effort. Would you prefer to hire someone who's demonstrated that they've got practice, or someone who's demonstrated that they've got dreams? I bet you you're going to build your house on the back of someone who's shown you in the world that they can produce the result that you want. You have to show the world what you're capable of, and if they're looking at their phone, that's where you need to be. So how do you produce content? How do you be there when they're there? Because that newsfeed goes forever, and that piece of content you did yesterday expired. You can't send people back and back and back, because they don't fucking care. They want something new, and that's how their attention works. So you have to do it now, and you have to do it all the time, and it's never gonna stop. If you're resisting it today, you're gonna be irrelevant, because nobody can see you. In order to be seen, you have to produce content. In order to produce content, you have to talk at a camera. So how can you produce content at scale? You can do one or two things a week that we call macro content. This is an example. This is a video blog. It's going to be longer format. We're going to be able to take this content and break it down into bite-sized chunks and distribute that across our social platforms. And different people are going to see different content at different times, and it's going to distribute in different ways because of that engagement. And it's going to be unique. And we're going to do it every week until the end of time, until I learn that something else is better, something else that can replace this will produce a better return. But I don't know what that is. Gary Vee said, hire a guy, put a camera in his hand, tell him to point it at you and say something meaningful. And we're about to go help one of our clients do the same. He makes money. He knows how to put people in front of his streams, and he can convert those people into customers who, in fact, fulfill his dreams. So you should start now, and you should start by producing something like this, a video blog. You just need to talk and get comfortable in front of him. You can't see him, but in fact, he's you, because I'm looking through this lens trying to produce something new. And I'm done with that. We're gonna go to work today. We're gonna go do 8 hours of hard work. We're gonna help this customer produce the highest quality content we can. He cares. He has a product that helps people. He's got testimonials and social proof. He's got an audience waiting for him to show up today so that they can witness his live workshop without leaving the comfort of their own home. And you can do this too. And if you do, film it. It'll end up on your computer. You can hire someone like us to cut it up, make it relevant, wrap it in some cool creative, and put it online. And if you do that in some quantity per week that's more than everyone else, you'll be more relevant, because you'll be in front of the customers who matter most to you. So, let's get started. Today we're gonna show you behind the scenes. It's gonna be a good time. Warren's helping. He's here. Actually, in fact, Warren leads the show.
Well, sort of.
You're the director.
In a way.
Okay. No credit.
I'll take some credit.
A little.